Finished the third set chain high bar squat. Legs are feeling good today, so went up from 10 pounds from last week. So today I got 205, not including the chain weight. So really happy with that. It like, I don't know, just felt really powerful today, so decided to go up a little bit more. Usually I like to stay around 5-10 pound increase each week. So today's 10, so really happy with that. Everything was smooth. Just running through my head as I go. Kind of feet placement equal width apart. Shoot up as fast as I can, like I'm just shooting off the ground. Make sure depth is good. And then as I'm in the hole, just literally try and get up as fast as I can. Stay tight and just execute. So, did really well today. We have split squat. And I'm going to see if I can do that. We have 4 sets of 10 this week, so I have to do that with all the other accessories. So, catch you guys in a second. Here we go. About to do set 4 and split squats. I have 105 on the bar. There's nothing like leg day. I sweat so bad during this, like dripping. But here we go. Let's get it. What's going on, guys? It's 8 o'clock. I just got home from Legacy. We finished kickboxing, so right now I'm taking little Brody out for a walk. Finished eating and just kind of hanging out now, just kind of decompressing from the day. But it was a good day. We had some good rounds in, 3 rounds of pad work, and then again went running, which you saw in the clip before this one, like a mini part of it. So that's a major hill that we run up a lot. It's on a road called Tench Road, and it's just like a massive hill. Like, it never gets any easier. It's 1/2 mile, but it's a killer. So today we only had to run to Sims and do 1 lap instead of 2 like on Monday, and So I got some extra cardio in. But yeah, those are the only 2 days that I'm actually doing cardio. I'm not doing any more outside of that at the gym. Just Monday, Wednesday with kickboxing, and then that's it. But finished dinner, had some like stuffed peppers with some rice and ground turkey in it, and some like fat-free cheese. And probably to top off my macros, I'm gonna have like a yogurt or like a protein shake or something, because I still have like about like 30 grams of protein to eat. So after his walk, I'm gonna do that, and then just kind of relax the rest of the night, listen to a podcast. I recently started Steffi Cohen's Hybrid Unlimited podcast, and it's actually really, really good. And just the talks that they have, it's like they can talk about fitness, they can talk about lifestyle, their business, current events, or like what's going on, just anything, honestly. And it's very I don't know, I feel like I'm engaged in like just listening the whole time, because I've sometimes I get a little like, I guess, I don't know, distracted. And whenever I'm doing like either schoolwork or something, or like listening to the radio, I won't like fully listen, but I find myself with this particular podcast just really into it the whole time. And they're not so long, and they're not short either. They're roughly around like 40 minutes to an hour each, and it's really interesting. Some book references that she has, some quotes that I really, really like, and just her take on certain topics and stuff like that. So if you guys have time and are interested, she does have a podcast on iTunes, so go check that out. But yeah, so that's going to conclude today. Tomorrow is going to be an off day from the gym and from kickboxing, just total off day. So I'll just be at work, and then I have some clients that I'm going to FaceTime, train them, one in the morning and then one in the afternoon after work. And that'll be it. So I'll have to film Friday's workout, which will be the that'll be deadlift day. So show y'all that. But that's going to conclude today. So I'll see you guys Friday. What's going on, guys? So this was the lift for today. It's Friday. And so I get a lot of questions asking me, like, why do I do these particular pause deadlifts or this type of variation? So this is just from floor to about knee. So you just move up a couple of inches and you try and maintain, you're working on your form. So that initial feet placement, like your lats being engaged, and just running through your cues of like how, like guide the bar up against your legs, and maintaining tightness as you lift up, not rounding your back. Just working on form. And then as well as, that's a lot of the times you'll find with powerlifters, or just, I mean, anyone lifting in general who wants to do deadlifts, that's a sticking point. So a lot of the times, if you're able to get a weight up or not, is from your initial start point from the floor. And then you can also work on, like, with rack pulls, like the like hip extension phase, or the second part of the movement. But yeah, so this one is just working on the initial form and then the weight that I'm actually able to lift off the floor. So I'm not coming up to a full deadlift. But this has been a new thing that we've added into my program, and I've been really liking it. I do have like a 3 second pause at my knee. So just focusing on that right now during my hypertrophy cycle. And I've been enjoying it. And if it's something you guys are interested in, you guys can add it to your program as well. I am doing 3x5s on those with a 3 second pause. That's what Justin has me on right now. And so we'll see, because we're probably starting a strength phase here pretty soon. Because I'm going to try, we're looking at meets in December for me to do. So definitely want to do one. I think my body's capable of doing another one. But we'll see again with this whole COVID situation, if things will end up getting worse, or they'll just cancel meets altogether for the rest of the year. So just kind of play that one by ear. But just taking this off season to really grow and gain muscle, lean muscle mass, and strength overall, honestly. So, but yeah, so I get that question a lot, so I just wanted to explain that. And the ones about chains as well. Why do I use chains in my workouts? And that's just, again, that constant tension on the movement. So for instance, with squats, the top of the movement, that's gonna be the heaviest with the chains. And you can do it with bands as well. It's just adds a whole nother level to your lift and just resistance. So I think it does have its effects in your overall strength gain. So again, another additional exercise or variation that you can add. And right here I'm doing speed bench chains, or with chains. And to see my progress from the first time I did these for reps to now is insane. Like today, I felt like I was moving it so much faster than I had been any other day. So I was really happy with the progress I've been making and just sticking to the plan and knowing that it's been working. So just staying consistent and working hard, and that's it. All right, guys, so Friday night, we're doing our walk of the day. Usually when I get home from work, we'll both have dinner and then kind of walk around the neighborhood. It does look like it's about to rain, so we probably won't get as long of a work or walk as we would like, but we're gonna see what we can do. But yeah, overall, really great day. Just spoke about how those variations have been helping out and just been feeling good overall. So really excited. Tomorrow I do have bench, my second bench day, so I'm looking forward to that and all the accessories that come with it. So that's going to conclude this video. Thank you guys so much for watching if you have kept up with the end of this video. So I will catch up with you guys tomorrow.